In Slovakia, the Russian delegation dominated the Winter University Games, especially in cross-country. Russia has invested heavily in university sports, so the standard of their athletes is really high. Here's the president of their student sports union.
We really think that Universiade, especially, is a very good chance for young athletes as a reserve for national team, come here to as to demonstrate their potentials and to be in the future, present the country on the top level event like Olympic Games and World Championships.
17 cross-country medals, including 7 golds. The Russian students, supported by a comprehensive state system from the Ministry of Sport down, and the Russian Student Sports Union has set up a selection program which is seemingly working well. Andriy Fella, the winner of the 10-kilometer classic race, one of the beneficiaries.
Just a few days before Universiade, Federation decided to include him as a member of Russian delegation. And we celebrated here, just arrived January 22nd, and it was his birthday. So we, in our delegation, we celebrated, congratulated him. And for him, it was really a chance to demonstrate he is ready. He is one of the best, and he'd like to be a member of national team. So today we have seen the result.
Well, Andriy Fella was so motivated that he won the race, beating 2 other Russians, Atam Nikolaev and Valery Gonchar. What a day for him. The 5-kilometer classic race for women, and Anastasia Slonova gave it everything. Good enough for silver, but not enough to displace the defending champion. Oksana Usatova may have won before, but the Russian selection process is tough, and every time she competes, she has to prove she's one of the best. The race was very important for me, you know, because it's my favorite discipline, the 5-kilometer classic. But some people didn't have faith in me in the sprint, so today I wanted to prove that I was able to win. At the last Universiade, the Russian women's relay team finished only 9th. So here in Strepsko Plesso, the team was highly motivated. Usatova, the first to go, and she established a lead that was never in danger. Silver for Kazakhstan, and the French would take the bronze. A student of sports and tourism in Kazan, 25-year-old Andrei Larkov would bring the Russian men's team home ahead of the field. It's my first Universiade, and I'll certainly remember the games because the competitions went really well for our team and for me. Larkov had already won gold in the first competition, the men's sprint. And he bagged a 3rd gold as part of an all-Russian podium in the men's 30-kilometer mass start. In cross-country, the rest of the world could only look on and learn.
I think that they are fast racers, and it gives us all someone to chase, and it makes me want to train harder year-round to be able to get higher places. So.
The Russian stranglehold in cross-country was broken only by Anastasia Slonova of Kazakhstan, the winner of 2 gold medals in the women's sprint and the 15 kilometers mass start. 26 of the 68 events in the Winter Universiade were contested in Slovakia. The rest were held in Spain. 1,180 athletes from 41 nations came together for the snow competitions in the Sierra Nevada and the ice competitions in Granada. The men's Super G raced on a difficult Universiade track. Of the 54 competitors, 12 didn't reach the finish line. Italy's Michelangelo Tentori was the winner by 1/100th of a second. Marco Oliveras from Andorra, the unlucky runner-up.
It was a very great day today. The slope was fantastic. The slope was amazing. The track is a perfect day. and I skied very well, especially at the second part of the track.
6 days later, Tentori got another gold, this time in the giant slalom. The Italian, quicker than his teammate Rocco Del Sante, by almost 1.5 seconds. The Frenchman, Jonas Fabre, third. So with two golds in his pocket, Tentori, clearly a man of ambition.
It's important, but I hope that it's only the beginning and the best is yet to come.
The most successful female skier, Norway's Christina Åsberg. And with victory in the Super-G and the giant slalom, Christina certainly fulfilling her potential.
I did some great races back home in Norway before this, and I came here with a lot of confidence. I hope that I can make more great results and ski up to my potential. Then I will be really satisfied if I can do that.
On to snowboarding, and after the Olympic title, now the Universiad title, and Patricia Kummer building up an impressive medal collection in parallel giant slalom. She'd taken part in the Universiad twice before, and she'd arrived in the Sierra Nevadas with high ambitions. I'm mega happy. I really can't believe it, because I'd already taken part twice. In the first, I was seventh, then fourth. So I said to myself, that's like -3 all the time, isn't it? That means that next time I can win it. And it happened. I'm so glad. Patricia is at the University of Bern taking a master's degree in neuropsychology. But right now, her sports career is taking precedence. She knows many of the competitors from the World Cup and the Olympics, so victory here was really sweet. It was super. I wasn't satisfied with the second qualification run, but then, from the first final run onwards, I really had the rhythm. I raced perfectly, except for one small mistake. I was able to perform just the way I wanted. In the final run, Patrizia defeated Selina Jürg of Germany, with the bronze going to the Italian Nadia Ochner. In her third Universiad, Kummer had achieved her goal of a gold medal. I always said this was a title I wanted to win. I always want to win when I set out my goals, so now to obtain this victory, super fun. The men's competition was close too, and there was a high-caliber final with Daniel Weiss of Germany defeating the South Korean Choi Bo-gun, who's eighth in the FIS international rankings. Austria's Alexander Peyer took the bronze.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders. When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.